And this video is education purpose only. Today I am going to talk on molecular orbital energy levels. This topic is belong to the molecular orbital theory. Especially I am going to talk on molecular orbital energy levels in human nuclear diatomic molecule. And these molecules belong to the second period elements. You know that second period are, you know, lithium, beryllium, then boron, then carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine and neon. Out of that, first one is formation of here boron molecule, B2 molecule. B2 belong to the third A group and period number second. You know that boron has atomic number 5 and ground state electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. Ground state electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. In first 1s orbital, 2 electrons are there. In 2s orbital, 2 electrons, and in 2p orbital, single electron is present. There is a large distance between that 1s orbital and 2s orbital energy levels. Therefore, 1s orbitals are non-bonding molecular orbitals when molecular orbitals are formed. And only here 2s orbitals and 2p orbitals take part in the bonding and atomic orbitals combine and there is a formation of molecular orbitals. If you see the molecular orbital energy level diagram, for B2 molecule, you know that B2 molecule is formed by the combination of two boron atoms. Boron has atomic number 5 and ground state electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. Out of that, here 1s orbital, when combined with second 1s orbital of boron, here there is a non-bonding molecular orbital formation and only 2s orbital and 2p orbital take part in the bonding. And here molecular orbital energy level diagram is represented here energy. Here is a 2s orbital. And in 2s orbital, you know that there are 2 electrons. This orbital is 2s orbital. This is second 2s orbital for second boron atom. And again, 2 electrons are there. This is 2s. Then these two atomic orbitals combine and there is a formation of 2 molecular orbitals. One is known as bonding molecular orbital and second is antibonding molecular orbital. Then total 4 electrons are there in 2s atomic orbitals and here in bonding molecular orbital pairing of electron take place and in antibonding molecular orbital again 2 electrons are there. This is called as atomic orbital. This is atomic orbital and that middle are molecular orbitals. That middle are molecular orbitals. This bonding molecular orbital is represented as sigma and antibonding molecular orbital is represented as sigma star. It is represented as sigma star. And as a rule of molecular orbital theory, whatever atomic orbitals combine, that much molecular orbitals are formed. And here 2s atomic orbitals of boron atom combine and 2 molecular orbitals are formed. One is sigma and second is sigma star. This is called as bonding molecular orbital and this is known as antibonding molecular orbital. Then there are 3p orbitals and these 3p orbitals are degenerate one. These 3p orbitals are degenerate one and there is overlapping or combination of these 3p orbitals. This is a 2p orbital and this is a 2p orbital. You know there are 3p orbitals. These 3p orbitals are px, py and pz. Again, second boron atom contain single electron in px orbital and then there is overlapping of these atomic orbitals or combination of atomic orbital take place and here this is called as pi 2py equal to pi 2pz. This is sigma 2px. This one is pi star 2py equal to pi star 2pz and upper is here sigma star 2px. Then these two electrons goes to the ground state in px orbital and one electron is present in pi 2py and second electron is present in pi 2pz. Then pi 2py is equal to pi 2pz and it has a smaller energy as compared to the sigma 2px and pi star 2py is equal to pi star 2pz has higher energy as compared to the pi 2py equal to pi 2pz and sigma star 2px and this is the molecular orbital energy level diagram for B2 molecule. Then there is a determination of bond order and bond order is equal to 1/2 into the number of electrons in bonding molecular orbitals minus number of electrons in antibonding molecular orbitals. The formula for determination of bond order in various molecule is equal to 1/2 into number of electrons present in bonding molecular orbitals minus number of electrons present in antibonding molecular orbital. In B2 molecule, you know that lower one are the bonding molecular orbital, two electrons, and here two electron, total is equal to 1/2 into the bracket 4. Then in antibonding molecular orbitals, two electrons are there, here 4 minus 2, and that is 1/2 into 2, that is equal to 1. Means bond order in B2 molecule is equal to 1. Bond order, there is a single bond between two boron atoms. There is single bond between two boron atoms and that bond order is determined by formula. Bond order is equal to 1/2 into the bracket number of electrons present in bonding molecular orbitals minus number of electrons present in antibonding molecular orbital, that value is equal to 1 and single bond is present in B2 molecule. Single bond is present in B2 molecule. Then if you see the stabilization energy, shortly it is represented as SE. Stabilization energy. Here stabilization energy is equal to number of electrons present in bonding molecular orbitals multiply by minus beta plus number of electrons present in antibonding molecular orbitals multiply by plus beta. Formula is नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स प्रेजेंट इन बॉन्डिंग मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल मल्टीप्लाई बाय माइनस बीटा प्लस नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स प्रेजेंट इन एंटी बॉन्डिंग मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल्स मल्टीप्लाई बाय प्लस बीटा. हेयर इन बॉन्डिंग मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल फोर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर देयर. देयरफॉर दिस वैल्यू इज इक्वल टू माइनस फोर बीटा प्लस टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर प्रेजेंट इन एंटी बॉन्डिंग मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल हेयर प्लस टू बीटा एंड टोटल इज इक्वल टू माइनस टू बीटा. मीन्स स्टेबिलाइजेशन एनर्जी फॉर बी टू मॉलिक्यूल इज इक्वल टू माइनस टू बीटा एंड इट इज अ स्टेबल मॉलिक्यूल. बी टू मॉलिक्यूल इज स्टेबल मॉलिक्यूल. इफ यू सी द एनर्जी ऑर्डर फॉर दिस डायटोमिक मॉलिक्यूल हेयर एनर्जी ऑर्डर एट द ग्राउंड लेवल यू नो देर इज वन एस ऑर्बिटल एंड इन वन एस ऑर्बिटल हेयर टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर देयर एंड देर इज टू मच डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू एस ऑर्बिटल एंड वन एस ऑर्बिटल एनर्जी लेवल्स. देयरफॉर दे फॉर्म्स द नॉन बॉन्डिंग मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल एंड जनरली इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिग्रेशन इज रिप्रेजेंटेड फॉर बी टू मॉलिक्यूल इज के के वेयर के इज इक्वल टू फर्स्ट सेल. यू नो दैट इन एटम के एल एम एन सेल्स आर देयर. वन एस ऑर्बिटल के सेल. टू एटोमिक ऑर्बिटल्स ऑफ बी टू आर देयर. दीज आर वन एस एंड देयर फोर डबल के इज रिप्रेजेंटेड देयर. देन इन सिग्मा हेयर सिग्मा टू एस टू. देन हेयर सिग्मा स्टार 2s2. Then here pi 2py1. Then pi 2pz1. This is the electronic configuration for B2 molecule according to the molecular orbital energy level diagram. In molecular orbital energy level diagram for B2 molecule, here two unpaired electrons are present in pi 2py equal to pi 2pz and therefore this B2 molecule is paramagnetic in nature. This B2 molecule is para. You know the diamagnetic and paramagnetic. Diamagnetic means all electrons are paired. And paramagnetic means some unpaired electrons are there. Two unpaired electrons are present in B2 molecule. Therefore, B2 molecule is paramagnetic in nature. And this is the molecular orbital energy levels for B2 molecule. B2 molecule is second period element. And in second period element, there is quite change in energy order. You know that in energy order there is sigma 1s has smaller energy as compared to sigma star 1s has smaller energy. Sigma here 2s has smaller energy. Here sigma star 2s has smaller energy. Here pi 2py nearly equal to pi 2pz has smaller energy. Here sigma 2px smaller energy as compared to the pi star 2py equal to pi star. Here 2pz has smaller energy sigma star 2px. This is the general order for the energy level for the second series means second period element. What are that elements? These elements are lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, etc. Okay, in these elements that energy order is sigma 1s has smaller energy as compared to sigma star 1s has smaller energy as compared to the sigma 2s has smaller energy as compared to sigma star 2s. has smaller energy. Pi 2 Py nearly equal to pi 2 Pz has smaller energy. Sigma 2 Px. Pi star 2 Py equal to pi star 2 Pz has smaller energy. Sigma star 2 Px. If you see this energy level diagram, at the ground state, these non-bonding molecular orbitals are not shown. That are sigma 1s and sigma star 1s. But after that, here sigma 2s from 2s orbital, then sigma star 2s, then pi 2py, then pi 2pz, then sigma 2px, then pi star 2py equal to pi star 2pz, and then sigma star 2px. These are the molecular orbitals. In this energy level diagram, here these are the molecular orbitals, atomic orbitals for boron atom, that middle are molecular orbitals for boron B2 molecule, and here atomic orbital for boron atom. Here these are the atomic orbitals, middle are molecular orbitals. This is boron atom, this is B2 molecule, and this is boron atom again. And like that, there is a formation of an energy level diagram for various molecules. Second molecule is C2 molecule. Next molecule is C2 molecule, carbon molecule. C2 molecule is formed by combination of two carbon atoms. Carbon has atomic number 6 and ground state electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. In 2s orbital, two electrons are present, and in 2p orbital, again two electrons are present. There is a large gap or distance between 1s orbital and 2s orbital, and when there is a gap of energy, that 1s orbital from each carbon atom does not take part in formation of molecular orbital and remain as non-bonding molecular orbital. If you see the molecular orbital energy level diagram for carbon, these are suppose atomic orbitals, and this is a 2s orbital. This orbital is 2s orbital. Then it forms bonding, and antibonding molecular orbitals. Okay, this is a 2s orbital containing 2 electron. Here 2 electron in bonding molecular orbital. Here sigma 2s and here sigma star 2s is there. This is called as a bonding molecular orbital. This is known as antibonding molecular orbital. Bonding molecular orbital is sigma 2s. Antibonding molecular orbital is sigma star 2s. And these middle are molecular orbitals. Here this is atomic orbital as a 2s. Then next, if you see that energy level, this is pi 2py equal to pi 2pz. Above that pi 2pz, here is sigma 2px, and these are the p orbitals. This is 2p, and for carbon 2p2, 2 electrons are there. Then here second carbon atom, this is a 2p, and there are 2 electrons. Then there is again formation of bonding, and antibonding molecular orbital. These are pi 2py equal to pi 2pz, here sigma 2px, here pi star 2py equal to pi star 2pz, and this is sigma star 2px, and this energy order is followed by again C2 molecule. What is that energy order? Sigma 1s has smaller energy as compared to the sigma star 1s, has smaller energy as compared to the sigma 2s, sigma star 2s. Here is sigma 2s, has smaller energy as compared to the sigma star, has smaller energy as compared to pi 2py equal to pi 2pz, and these four orbital electrons here 1, 2, 3, 4 pairing is occur, means four electrons are present in pi 2py equal to pi 2pz. See that in this energy molecular orbital energy level diagram, 2s orbital contain 2 electrons, this 2s contain 2 electrons, and bonding and antibonding molecular orbitals are formed. Pi 2py equal to pi 2pz, here sigma 2px, pi star 2py equal to pi star 2pz, and if you see the bond order in C2 molecule, again formula is bond order is equal to 1 half into number of electrons in bonding molecular orbitals minus number of electrons present in antibonding molecular orbitals. Here in bonding molecular orbital 2 and 4 means 6 electrons are there. Then in antibonding molecular orbital 2 electrons are present. Here 4 divided by 2 is equal to 2. In C2 molecule bond order is equal to 2. In C2 molecule bond order is equal to 2. If you see the stabilization energy is equal to number of electrons present in bonding molecular orbitals multiply by beta plus number of electrons present in antibonding molecular orbitals multiply by plus beta, here minus 6 beta plus 2 beta is equal to minus 4 beta. There is a formation of C2 molecule and it is quite stable, but C2 molecule is in vapor state and there are all electrons paired. When all electrons are paired, this molecule is diamagnetic in nature. This molecule is diamagnetic in nature because all electrons are paired in C2 molecule. If you see the electron configuration by molecular orbital energy level, in molecular orbital energy level for C2 molecule, there is KK, then sigma 2s2, two electrons are present in bonding molecular orbital, then sigma star 2s2, then pi 2py2 equal to pi 2pz2, and this is the molecular orbital electron configuration for C2 molecule. Listen again, C2 molecule is formed by the combination of two carbon atoms. Carbon has atomic number 6 and ground state electronic configuration is 1s to 2s to 2p2. This electronic configuration is 1s to 2s to 2p2, and there is an energy gap between that 1s orbital and 2s orbital. Therefore, in molecular orbital energy level diagram, that 1s orbital is not represented because it remains as non-bonding molecular orbital, and only 2s orbital and 2p orbital take part in the combination. This is the 2s orbital containing 2 electron from first carbon atom. This is second 2s and 2p orbitals for second carbon atom, and there is a formation of C2 molecule as molecular orbitals, and they contain bonding and antibonding molecular orbitals, and from the diagram there is a determination of bond order. Bond order is equal to 2 for C2 molecule. Then stabilization energy is equal to minus 4 beta. Then there is no unpaired electron, therefore it is diamagnetic in nature. Then energy order is sigma 1s, has smaller energy as compared to sigma star 1s. And after pi 2py and pi 2pz, there is sigma 2px, means sigma 2px has higher energy as compared to the pi 2py and pi 2pz. And in pi 2py and pi 2pz, 4 electrons are present. All electrons are paired. It is diamagnetic in nature. Molecule is stable one. There is a double bond between C2 molecule for carbon-carbon double bonding is occur there. And when such type of arrangement is present, that molecule is diamagnetic in nature. And when diamagnetic in nature, it is in vapor state. Same way, if you represent N2 molecule, nitrogen has atomic number 7 and ground state is 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. 3 electrons are there. Here 3 electrons, here 3 electrons, and that 2 more electrons goes to the what? Sigma 2px. Bond order for N2 molecule is equal to here 8 minus 2, that is equal to 6. And there is a triple bond between two nitrogen atom, nitrogen triple bond nitrogen in N2 molecule. Out of these three bond, one bond is sigma bond and two bonds are pi bonds. Stabilization energy, you know that number of electrons present in bonding molecular orbitals multiply by minus beta, and number of electrons present in antibonding molecular orbitals multiply by just beta, you can find out stabilization energy. N2 molecule is a stable molecule. You know N2 acts as an inert one. Reason is that there is a triple bond between two nitrogen atoms, nitrogen, triple bond nitrogen. Out of that, one is a sigma bond and two are the pi bonds. Molecular orbital configuration is KK sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, pi 2py2, then pi 2pz2, and here sigma 2px2. All electrons are paired, therefore again N2 molecule is diamagnetic in nature. You know nitrogen, N2 is a gas, but there is a strong bond between two nitrogen atom, and three bonds are formed. Out of that, one is sigma bond and two are the pi bond, and same energy order is occur in N2 molecule. Means in B2 molecule, in C2 molecule, and in N2 molecule, this type of energy order is follow. What is that order? Pi 2py is equal to pi 2pz has a smaller energy as compared to sigma 2px in other molecular orbital energy level diagram. This pi 2px has smaller energy as compared to pi 2py and pi 2pz, and same way energy order is represented, and this is the N2 molecule, and N2 molecule is formed by the combination of two nitrogen atoms. There is a triple bond. It is a diamagnetic in nature. Reason is that all electrons are paired, and that is molecular orbital energy level diagram for N2 molecule. And these are the three molecules and their energy level diagram according to the molecular orbital theory. Okay, thank you.